So we talked about vectors, rows of data, and tables being matrices or data frames in R. So to create a vector, you have to use the combine function, so C. So every function in R is followed by round brackets, as you can see here. And inside the round brackets come the inputs or the arguments of the function, so everything that it needs to be able to perform its function. And you make an assignment, so this arrow, what does it do? It will create a variable. So by making an assignment, you're creating a variable called v here. And that's the result of the combine function with these inputs, with these arguments. So these are the elements that you want to store in the vector. You can create a vector by defining elements, but you can also create a vector by combining existing vectors. So that's basically what you do here. And you will make one long vector out of them. So this is for vectors. How to make a data frame? The same principle, but you use the data.frame function, and the arguments that you need to specify here are vectors. So the vectors that will make up the columns of your data frame. So once you have created your variables, you can do a lot of things with these variables using existing functions in R. That's what you do here. And these functions work exactly the same as the combine function and the data.frame function. They are followed by round brackets, and inside the round brackets, you define the input, the arguments. So how to retrieve elements from vectors or data frames? Well, you do that using the square brackets. So round brackets come after a function. Square brackets come after a variable. And the square brackets define that you want to retrieve something. So when you use them on a data frame, you have to write this comma inside the square brackets. So in front of the comma comes the rows that you want to retrieve. So when you don't put anything in front of the comma, it means all the rows. And after the comma comes the columns that you want to retrieve. So in this case, you want to retrieve the first column. You can do the same thing with vectors, but with vectors, you don't have to use the comma. You just write the index, the position of the element that you want to retrieve. So this will retrieve the first element. So when you use the name of a column inside the square brackets, you have to put that name in between quotes. Single or double quotes, that doesn't matter, but it has to be in between quotes. However, when you use one of the other ways to retrieve elements from a data frame, the dollar sign or the subset function, in these two cases, you don't have to put the names of the column in between double quotes. So here, this will retrieve the column called V1. It's inside square brackets, so you have to put the name in between quotes. Here you use the dollar sign to retrieve the column, so the name doesn't have to come in between double quotes. And the same thing here, inside the subset function, you don't have to use double quotes around the names of the columns. What is also strange the first times that you have to do it is every time that you use more than one in R, it doesn't matter what it is, more than one value, more than one index, more than one name, you have to use a vector. So if I want to retrieve two columns, so these are two names, more than one, I have to write that inside the combine function. And the last thing that I want to repeat is changing elements. Doesn't matter where, in a vector, in a data frame, every time you want to do a change, you have to make an assignment. So in front of the assignment comes what you want to change, so a retrieval. after the assignment comes the new value you want to give it.